Reflecting on his relatively brief tenure as Speaker, Ryan said, "I have accomplished much of what I came here to do." He named last year's tax overhaul and the budget deal reached last month to beef up military funding as two of his biggest achievements, and dismissed the idea that his decision to retire will affect Republican races for the midterm elections. Ryan also said the possibility of Democrats taking the House did not factor into his decision, and reiterated that he intends to finish the year in the leadership position. Ryan told colleagues of his decision before his Wednesday morning news conference. His top aide, Brendan Buck, said in a statement, "According to a person familiar with Ryan's decision, he made his choice over the latest two-week congressional recess with his wife, Yana, but an ongoing discussion about his future has been taking place for several months with a small group of his staff and his family." The person also said that Ryan has thoughts on who should succeed him as the Republican leader, and he will share them at a later time. Axios was the first to report that Ryan, 48, would leave Congress at the end of his term, which expires in January. According to a senior administration official, Ryan spoke with President Donald Trump about his decision earlier Wednesday morning, and the president then tweeted a message of support. "Speaker Paul Ryan is a truly good man, and while he will not be seeking re-election, he will leave a legacy of achievement that nobody can question. We are with you, Paul." Donald J. Trump, at Real Donald Trump, April 11, 2018. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell, RKY, said Wednesday that despite the stresses and pressures of being Speaker, Paul's optimism and energy never waned. "I'm glad we can count on his continued leadership through the rest of this year, because our work together is far from finished," McConnell said on the Senate floor. "I look forward to collaborating closely these next months to implement more of the inclusive, pro-growth, pro-opportunity agenda the American people are counting on us to keep advancing." Ryan, whose departure had been rumored for months, is the highest profile Republican to join the House's casualty list, which tracks members of the 115th Congress who have said they're leaving. According to the Tampa Bay Times, Representative Dennis Ross, Republican Florida, announced his retirement on Wednesday as well. Ryan was elected to the House 20 years ago and became Speaker in October 2015. He struggled to unite his party on the issues. Healthcare reform stalled, while failed negotiations over spending shut the government down. Ryan championed the GOP's tax cuts late last year, securing the lone major legislative victory of Trump's tumultuous first year in office. The top Democrat in the House, Rep. Nancy Pelosi of California, remarked on Ryan's commitment to his political beliefs. "The Speaker has been an avid advocate for his point of view and for the people of his district," the minority leader said in a statement. "Despite our differences, I commend his steadfast commitment to our country." Back home in Ryan's Wisconsin district, there are already a number of challengers lined up, including Democrat Randy Brice, who boasted Tuesday of strong fundraising numbers. He cheered Ryan's announcement with a joke about Republican efforts to repeal and replace Obamacare. "Breaking, we just repealed Paul Ryan. Oh, it's time to replace him. Chip in to help us build this campaign and give #WIO1. For the first time in 20 years, some real representation. https://t.co/sgsuzer. Randy Brice, at Iron Stash, April 11, 2018. Speaker Ryan sees what is coming in November, and is calling it quits, the Democratic Congressional Campaign Committee said in a statement. Stay tuned for more retirements as Republicans increasingly realize that their midterm prospects are doomed. Two Wisconsin Republicans had already announced bids for Ryan's seat. Paul Wynn, who challenged Ryan in 2016 and earned 15.9% of the vote, and veteran Nick Poles, whose campaign has not yet gained much traction. The filing date for the August primary is June 1, giving Republicans less than 2 months to rally additional candidates.